you'll have like a sound guy call you sweetheart and ask you if you know how to like turn on your amp, and like you'll say that to a man and he'll be like, us all sound guys are just assholes. And it's like, no, like that wouldn't happen to you.
There's arguably no band fighting harder to change Australian music than Camp Cope. They've launched campaigns against sexual assault at gigs, and their song The Opener made headlines when they called out Falls Festival, amongst other venues and festivals, for not having enough women on their lineup. Today, we are at the Sydney Opera House, where in a few days, Camp Cope will play Australia's most iconic stage, which is odd for a band whose most iconic song is all about being constantly told that women can't sell out big venues.
What was going on in your lives when you wrote The Opener? No, that's a good answer. We'll take that. That's all good.
It was like just a build-up of everything we'd experienced, every bit of criticism that we'd been given by men. And it was really easy. I just used like direct quotes. I didn't write the end of the song. All the men that criticised me wrote the end of the song.
Yeah.
I just wrote it down.
I remember the first time Georgia sent it to us. I was like listening to it and I was like, oh, because I was obviously there when all of this stuff has been said to us. And I was like, how'd she get all that to rhyme? It's pretty good.
Yeah, just get it.
Music community, because that's what it is. It's just not represented properly. It's bullshit and we've had enough of it.
We were at that point, I think, as a band where we were selling out our shows. We were doing really well. We hadn't even imagined we were getting to the point where we were. And then we still had people who didn't even play music or things like that criticizing us and telling us still how to do things. And it's like, when you sent that song, we were at that moment where we should have been respected and we should have been seen like we knew what we were doing, but people still weren't treating us that way. People were still giving us their advice if they were in a band that played much smaller venues or hadn't even been played on the radio, but felt like they had to tell us what to do or what we did wrong or what we should do the next time and things like that. And you wrote it just at that moment, I think, before things started to shift.
Yeah.
Was there a moment when you concluded that the lack of respect you're getting was based on gender? Or was that something that you'd always known from coming out?
That's something that you just always know as a woman.
You always know it, but then what really surprised me was that the men didn't know it.
Yeah.
So like that was the kind of, that's what pushed us to start speaking and being more open about it, because we would be like, oh, you know, people are saying this to us, people are doing this, we've, you know, this has happened to us. And then someone would be like, do you think that's because you're a woman? And I've had these conversations and I've said, has it happened to you or your friends? And they'd be like, no. And it's like, why? When we're in the same position as you, why do you think it hasn't happened to you, but it's happened to us?
What's the one thing that separates us?
Yeah. Or like, you'll have like a sound guy call you sweetheart and ask you if you know how to like turn on your amp. And like, you'll say that to a man and he'll be like, us all sound guys are just assholes. And it's like, no, like that wouldn't happen to you. Yeah. Like, when is like some man working ever called you sweetheart? Like, it's so like gross.
I don't know, there's different levels of noticing it, I think. Like, I remember a huge one for me was when we were here last time, like before we played here. And a friend of ours who's a musician said to me, like sent me a message and said, hey, like you should talk to my friend about like booking for you guys and like managing you guys. And I was like, why? Like, you haven't played the Opera House. Their bands haven't played here. Like, what have we done so wrong that like you have to think that someone else has to do my job for me? Like, we're doing fine by ourselves. Like, what makes you think that you have an opinion on who should do things for us? Or what's wrong with playing 2 sold out shows at the Drama Theatre? Could I do better? What do you want me to do? Play in the concert hall?
All right.
Fine. So what happened was we got this man to book us and now we're playing in the concert hall.
Ah, this is ruining the narrative.
It always has been a boys' club. I remember when I was like really young going to shows and it would just be like 4 white men, 4 white men, 4 white men. And then you'd be like lucky sometimes and you're like the female, you know, acoustic opener.
In terms of the reaction after the headlines, in terms of the reactions you got from people online, there's an emotional impact to kind of being involved in those conversations. What does that do to you guys, being at the centre of that?
The most annoying thing was the people who were like, oh, they're doing it for attention. It's like, do you think we're having a nice time right now? Like, this isn't fun. Like, we're trying to say something. Everyone in the music industry is being silent. Yeah. So we look like it's not a problem, and we're just being like,
We're
complaining, because like no one would back us up. I was calling for it, I'm like, please. I don't know, it was a strange time, but it certainly wasn't fun.
Yeah, it takes a lot out of you.
No, it's not fun. Yeah. I didn't like it. I didn't want to do it, and I never want to do it, but it's really nice having a group of people to do it with and give you support. And I feel like that's made all the difference, and that's made it, like, made us able to continue doing it.
I had to say no and stop more than once, way too many times.
Walk me through the decision-making process to include Face of God in the album, because it's obviously a song that touches on some very personal, quite traumatic stuff. What were you thinking when you decided, yes, that needs to be out in public?
Yeah, I was really scared people were going to be like, well, who is it about? Like, where's the evidence? Like, you know, the usual stuff when someone comes out about sexual assault, like they don't get believed because there's no evidence or something. Or like people are going to say that, like, just doing it for attention. Like, that's what I was really scared of what people would say about it. And then the Me Too movement happened and I was like, right, I'm not afraid to tell everyone my story. Like, I didn't sit down and be like, all right, this is how I'm gonna get past my sexual assault, I'm gonna write a song about it. It's just like, it just kind of like happens. It just, the song just kind of like writes itself, and I'm like channeling, I'm just like a vessel.
All of the stuff that happened in the last 6 months was like, I don't know, gave us a bit more confidence that people would not, I don't know, chastise us for it, I suppose.
And the end result has been, it's really spoken to people,
yeah.
Like that song means so much to the people that hear it.
It's really heartbreaking, but yeah, you get this feeling of solidarity with every other person who's experienced what the song's detailing.
How do you measure success as a band for you? How do you know that works, that's us, that's Camp Code?
The most successful I ever feel is when a young girl will come up and talk to us about what we do and how she wants to make music. Having someone say that we've inspired them to like keep plowing through everything and just kind of like do their thing and keep doing it. That's when I feel most successful.
Yeah.
So there's the line at the end of the song, look how far we've come. As you stand here in the middle of the Opera House about to play the concert hall, is there some poetic justice to that?
I don't know, it still feels weird that we can do that.
We're already way ahead of where I ever thought we'd be, and it's really, like, I'm already so proud of us. Like, that, the end of that song, like, look how far we've come not listening to you, it's like, we've already surpassed what I thought was possible doing things by ourselves, and it just keeps, you know, proving me wrong, I guess, every time as we move forward and forward. So, I don't know, it embodies the whole, it's not just like one particular show in a great space, it's like the whole thing. Like, we've done it all by ourselves and we've done it together.
Camp Cope, play a fucking awesome show at the Opera House, and thank you so much for
joining us. Thank you.